I've never done baby dedication, so I'm not educated on how to do it. But I've been praying all week, or praying longer than that. And Justin and Sister Brianna actually said to me, said, we want you to do the baby dedication. I said, ooh, okay. I said, you want Sister Sloan, Brother David? She said, no, we want you. You started it, so you're going to finish it. I said, all right. All right. Just a quick story. Met Brother Justin and his family first. He was a kid. And you were younger than that. Yeah. So about 15. Most aggravating youngin I've ever met in my life. Oh my God. He drove me up the wall and down the other side. And he would want to sit and talk to me for hours. And I would sit in Georgia and we would talk for hours and hours until I would fall over. And we would talk. I'm telling this story, sitting there and hush. And we would sit and talk, and he would talk about the Bible and all this kind of stuff, and he'd ask questions. And anyway, and then we met Brother Spencer and Sister Carolyn, and Sister Brianna was, how old was your baby? He was 8. How old was your baby? She was little bitty. And we met them and became such good friends with all of them, and we stayed in their home and all kind of stuff. And how many knows that God has a plan for things?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You don't never know what God's going to do and how he's going to perform stuff. Justin had told me, he said, if I ever get married, is what he said to me, he said, God will have to just drop her in my lap because I just don't want anything. He said, I'm not going to go looking. I even tried to set him up a couple times, a couple girls, and he was like, no, she's weird. No. I'm like, okay.
Yep.
Whatever. However, this thing right here, I did not do. Your mama did it. I don't know if y'all know this. Sister Arnell text him and said, I think you'd be a good match for my granddaughter. Justin said, ma'am, what?
I was like, no.
He said, no, she's too young for me. Justin asked me, he said, do you know that woman texted me and said that to me? And he said, maybe I shouldn't have told nobody, but I don't know about that. Anyway, long story short, they got together. It was a rocky getting together. Oh, my Lord. Sister Brianna would call me, and Justin would call me, and they would get mad, and they would break up. I was like, I don't want to hear it.
No, we would not break up. She would break up with me.
I want you to be quiet. I'm telling this story. I distinctly remember you don't turn one time, too.
So,
it was a mess. Hallelujah. It was a mess. And how many know sometimes God takes a mess, makes a message out of it? They were broke up, and they came here to Labor Day Fest. Acted like 2-year-olds and would not speak to each other. Would not speak to each other. It was pitiful. Pitiful. And I told them, see, I didn't have a dog in the race. I wanted them to be happy. If they were happy together, that's great. If they were happy apart, I was happy with that too. Whatever they wanted. But somehow, I got pulled in the middle of it. And this is how the story happened. I do believe I'm going to tell all their secrets to them.
Go ahead.
Because I know all of them.
You better not.
Sister Brianna left him a letter in his Bible telling him all kinds of stuff. I didn't get to read all that, but just told him all kinds of stuff. And Justin came to my house and he said, I don't understand that she won't talk to me, but she left me a letter. We all went to eat, Sister Megan and us and this and that. And Justin said, well, I don't know. I'm just going to leave it alone. I'm this, I'm that. And he told a portion of the letter to Sister Megan what Brianna said to him. And Megan looked at Justin and said, that girl loves you. And you need to ask her to marry you.
Oh, my God, Justin, marry that girl.
Yes.
That was her exact word.
And he said, Justin said, no, I'm not. I don't know, it was this stuff going on. I said, you'll never do it, because I know Justin. I said, you'll never do it unless you just do it. That's what you want to do. So she was on her way back to Georgia. Brianna was on her way back to Georgia. Now, mind y'all, let me explain something. We've been to their church, us. And we've been to their church. We've ministered in both of their churches. Just keep that in mind. Okay? Keep that in mind. Brenda turned her car around and came back. She was 100 miles away.
Yeah.
Turned the car around and came back. And the thing is, God has ways of doing things. I had a dream about a few months before that, and I didn't know what it meant. But I saw a chapel in my backyard. And it came down, and there was an engagement ring on the door of the chapel and had Justin's name written on it. And I told Justin about it. He said, well, I don't know what that means. So Brianna turned around and came back, and we was on our way back home. I was riding with Justin. And I don't know if Justin has ever told Brianna this. This boy right here lost it. He was driving. And he cried all the way from Corinth, Mississippi, to my house. Yes. And then he would laugh, and then he would cry some more, and he said, I think I love her. I think I love her. And I was like, you think? You think? He was driving my car. And I said, can you pull over and let me drive? Because I know you can't see. No, I'm going to drive. Mess. This is what happened. He picked up a ring from Walmart. Wasn't her. He had her another one, but he didn't have it with him because he didn't think his gonna ask her anyway much stuff. Picked up a ring from Walmart. I live on almost a 90-degree angle. Because Brianna had come to the end of the driveway. Justin runs down my driveway, falls on his knees and asks her on the side of the highway and asks her to marry him. I guess she said yes. That happened at my house. Uh-huh. And they came back up the hill, and when they got in the house, Justin and Brenda looked at me, and Brenda said, we want to get married. And I said, well, okay, I'm happy for you. She's like, no, we want to get married now. And I'm like, hold on just a minute. I said, you're going to call your mom and daddy and tell them. She said, no. No, we're not. And I said, she was 19, but I know her daddy. And that's his baby girl. And this one was an adult, completely been out on his own. And I know it was Spencer Kelly. And I said, and she said, I want you to do it. And I said, No. She said, well, this is, and she's talking, she said, both of us, she's like, well, you're the reason that we're together, and this is that. I said, don't you put this on me. I had nothing. And I said, you can't get married in Mississippi unless you're 21 without a signer. She said, well, what about Tennessee? And I was like, who knew? Justin said, I'm going to look it up.
Tried Alabama first.
And then Tennessee, and all this time I'm thinking, Spencer Kelly's gonna kill me. I love Bill Spencer, he's a good man, great provider, but I just thought to myself, he gonna come to Mississippi, and he gonna chop off both of my hands and both of my feet.
And put them on a t-shirt.
That's right. Saying, I killed Tina Horn. Brenda said, I want to marry Justin tomorrow. And I said, all right then. And I said, you need to call your mom and dad. She said, no, I'm going to call them after. I said, no, you're going to call them before. She said, no, I'm not going to call them before. It's my decision. I was like, do you? And I looked at her. I remember this distinctly. I said, do you know your dad?
Said,
he'll be all right.
He'll be all right.
No, baby girl said that. I said, okay. So I rode in the vehicle to Tennessee, and the whole time we rode to Tennessee, Selmer, Tennessee, and the whole time I was in the back seat and I was praying. I said, oh God, this can't. I don't know what we're going to happen here. So we got the license and we came back, and I told Mama, I said, they want me to get married like today. It's now. They got the license. She said, where do they want to get married at? And Justin said, well, it started at the tabernacle down here. So we'll just get married here. And my mama, in all of her wonderfulness, went and rented an arch. Said, okay, if we're going to get married, then we're going to give them a wedding. So I married them. That was the first time I'd ever did a ceremony, wedding ceremony. And after that, I said, y'all have to call your parents. I wasn't as much worried about Brother Terry, as Justin has grown. I was concerned about this one. I thought, I'm gonna put a few miles between me and the Kellys when y'all make this phone call. So they were sitting at our table, and I can't remember which one did you call first. Yeah, hers. I think that was my, yes, that was my idea. I said, you call them and tell them. When they told, I heard silence on one end, and I heard his parents say, Chelsea? That's her middle name. She said, Chelsea, what did you do? I said, I didn't have nothing to do. Then I had to repent because I did. How many knows God has a plan? They still love us, I reckon. Still love me. I said, listen, would you rather me done it or them to run off? Because they was determined. They was determined to get married. And he was like, okay, all right. And then they called Brother Terry and Sister Patty. Sister Patty was like, you're lying. Hey, that's the first thing. She said, you're lying. Quit playing. You're lying. She said, what are you doing? I said, Angie, let them talk to the two. And Sister Patty, that's
it was my house.
Word that Sister Patty said, you're lying, Justin. Quit lying. That ain't funny. Quit lying. That's not stuff funny. And I said, I got the phone. I said, Sister Patty, you're not lying. And she said, oh, my God. Oh. It's just amazing. But that brings me to this today. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. How many knows that 8 means a new beginning? It was very strange numbers. You got married on the 8th. At 8th of September.
And known each other 8 years.
And there was 8 people at the wedding. Brother Robert Chilman preached about a full circle coming 8.
8 years.
For rings, $8.88.
His ring was $8.88.
We got married at 4:40.
It was something for 48.
Anyway.
There was a lot of 8s.
A lot of 8s. So God designed a great thing. I want y'all to come sit right here. And then the next thing they wanted was a baby. And I don't know how many know this, but according to statistics, Brother Justin was not actually supposed to be able to have children because of some things. How many knows God's got a plan?
Yeah.
I've never done one of these, but this is what the Lord spoke to me to do. In Psalms 127:3, all the way through 5, it says this. It says, lo, children are a heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. Today I want y'all to recognize something. I want you to recognize that this baby girl, Eleanor Rosalie, that's her name, Garrett. Eleanor Rosalie Garrett. That she is a precious gift from God. However, she don't belong to you. She's just on land. What God has entrusted you to do is what the scripture says, to raise her in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. And realize that you're training a human for the kingdom of God.
That's
you're training
great.
Someone to be a soul winner. You're training someone to be a minister. You got to cover all of them avenues because you don't know the plans that God's got for her. So you got to train her to be a singer. You got to train her to be a preacher. You got to train her to be a prayer warrior. Because in the future, you don't know what God has. So that's a big responsibility. People that just pop out kids all the time don't understand the responsibility of children. God gave them to you for a purpose. Not just to further your lineage, but to further the kingdom of God.
Yeah, that's right.
And it's a great responsibility. That's why I believe that people that forsake their children and abuse their children is a special place in hell for them.
All right.
Because the scripture says, lo, children are a heritage.
From the Lord.
Like I said, I've never done one of these before, but this is what God said to do.
Good. Keep on.
This ceremony today will not so much be for her as it is for you to realize and acknowledge that God's the ultimate authority. And he gave her to you just on land until the time comes for him to fulfill his purpose in her.
Yeah.
This is his commandment. This is what he said for you to do. He says, therefore, shall you lay up these my words in your heart and in your soul, and bind them for a sign upon your head, that they may be as frontlets between your eyes, meaning they shall guide you. And you shall teach them to your children, meaning the statutes and the laws of the Lord, to teach them to your children, speaking of them when thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. You know what that scripture says? It says you always teach them about Jesus. If they're running around in the yard, you say, you know, it's the Lord that gave you this beautiful sunshine that's shining now. You teach them that. You write them over the door. You write the scriptures over the door. And you shall write them upon the doorpost of thine house and upon the gates, that your days may be multiplied in the days of your children, and in the land which the Lord sware to your fathers to give them, as the days of heaven upon the earth. For you shall keep them diligently. This is the blessing. This is the blessing that God gave to Israel. But we call on it today and give it this blessing to this baby girl. And you as parents, if you do your job correctly, there's one more promise that God gives y'all.
Yeah.
If you do your job correctly as parents, it says, train up a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he shall not depart. That means if you do your job right and teach that baby girl by the nurture and admonition of the Lord, she might depart for a moment, might want to do her own thing sometime, but she'll come right back to it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, she'll come right back to it. It doesn't matter. If you as a parent, I'm saying this to anyone, do your job in the correct way. Your child might depart from God for a moment, but that spirit will lead them all the way back to it. Hallelujah, you have a great responsibility. It's not just to further who you are, to keep your name, none of that. It's not even to bring you joy. They do, but that's not what the sole purpose is. You are raising up someone to serve in the kingdom of God. That's why God gave you children. Everyone knows Hannah and how she prayed she wanted a baby so bad. She wanted one so bad. She wept and she cried and she promised God a promise. She said, God, if you'll give me a child, I'll give him back to you. And she did it in the extreme way, not the way that we do it. In a symbolic way, God, I'm giving this child back to you. She actually took that baby to the temple and gave it to the prophet. And this is what she said when she did it. And she said, oh, my Lord, as thy soul liveth, my Lord, I am the woman that stood by thee here praying unto the Lord. For this child I prayed, and the Lord hath given me my petition, which I ask of him. Therefore also I have lent him to the Lord. As long as he liveth, he shall be lent to the Lord, and he worshiped the Lord there. We do it in a symbolic way today. We dedicate our children back to God. But this woman actually, it would be the same as Sister Brianna saying, I'm a minister, I'm a preacher. Saying, here, take my baby girl, raise her in the house of God. No, she said, no. That's what?
Sacrifice.
That is what Hannah did. I need my husband. Where you at, love? Like I said, I've never done one of these. But about 3 o'clock this morning, God spoke this to me. Sister Brianna, don't let anybody touch her baby much. However, I don't ask. Because I'm as much part of him having her. Same way with Tasha. She wouldn't let no one get a hold of her. I prayed that baby here. I'll touch him whenever I get ready. Same way with this one. Same way with Sister Stacy's. I prophesied her here. I'll do whatever I want.
That's right.
I'll do what I will. So this is what God spoke to me. Need you to hold this mic. God's, if I can get through this without bawling. God said there was three blessings that I was to pronounce on this baby girl. There's more, but God said three. Hallelujah. Hold that in. I lay you, baby girl, in the Word of God, in the written Word of God. And I call on the blessings of Psalms 139 and 13. For thou hast possessed my reins, and thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. And marvelous are thy works that my soul knoweth right well. And the scripture that you're laying on, baby girl, is Jeremiah 29 and 11. For I know my thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not evil, that I'll give you an expected end. Then there's one more blessing, sweet girl. I call on the blessing of Aaron and Moses. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. And the Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. And baby girl, I bless you in the name of Jesus. I need grandpa's. Grandmas can come too in just a moment. I got y'all too. This is what the Lord spoke to me. It says children's children, not calling y'all old, Brother Spencer, Brother Terry. This is what the scripture says. Children's children are the crown of old men, and the glory of children are their fathers. You two are two great men of God. So this is what I want. I want you to pronounce a blessing on that grandbaby of y'all's. Just bow your head and pray.
Lord, every step that she takes, Lord, yes, will be for you, God. Lord, may God, Lord, you always keep a hedge around you, God. Lord, yes. That devil come out, God. Lord, on every side, God, she be protected. Your precious name, Jesus, God. Hallelujah.
For now, it's a blessing of a spiritual man. A spiritual man who reaches for God to reach for the supernatural.
This is what God spoke to me about the grandmas. I meant to give up that camera. Come on, sister. The Bible says for the older women to teach the younger how to raise their children. Hallelujah. So I want you to lay hands on Sister Brianna and the baby too. But all the knowledge they all have, God said it parted into her.
Yes.
You've had five, you've had two. Hallelujah. God said, you pronounce a blessing of motherhood.
Yes, Lord.
On this woman of God. Hallelujah. Go ahead and pray. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
Lord.
Thank you.
Let's put a little shy. Let's put a little shy. Don't be in the mic. This is what God said.
Yes, Lord.
And God, when the time comes, if time lasts, these great grandmamas who see this little one bring her own children into the world, they've tied to us. If you're a preacher in the house, I want you to come up here. Anyone else can come too if you want, but I want all ministers. Hallelujah. Just get around. Mom, Dad. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. After all the
ministers. Is there anybody else that wants to come again? Ministers, I want you to just touch them. Come on over. Lay hands on me. Hallelujah.
Yes, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Won't you lead this prayer, Mom?